I'm Lea Dosanjh. I'm an audiologist, and we are performing a listening check today on the BTE style of hearing aid. BTE is behind the ear. They come in rechargeable and battery driven. So the very first thing that you're going to want to do with this type of hearing aid is when you first turn it on, if no sound is coming out of it, you want to either change the battery or you want to put the hearing aid in the charger for at least 30 minutes so we can check to see if it's a low battery problem. After that, what we want to do is systemically try all of the different parts out to make sure that there's not something wrong with each individual part. So the first thing that you'll do is you'll grab a listener, something like this. And you're going to take the end of the ear mold with everything connected and put it into the tip of your listener and create a good seal. Then you'll use your Ling 6 sounds or a combination of vowels and consonants just to really test the functioning of the hearing aid. So you want to make sure that there's no distortion, there's no static, that nothing is coming through and sounding weak or vice versa too loud. I, U, E, O, R, SH, T, N, CH. The next thing that you'll want to check is if it's from the tone hook up. So if you take the ear mold off, usually it's just by pulling and wiggling a little bit on the tubing. And then you're going to put the tone hook down into the center part of the listener, again, creating a good seal. And you'll use those Ling 6 sounds again. I, U, E, R, SH, CH, T. And as you're going through, if the problem is still not solved by having taken the ear mold off, now we're going to take the tone hook off. And we'll run that same listening check again. I, U, E, R, SH, CH, T. And the hope is that as you're dissecting the hearing aid, you'll find the problem by taking something off. But if you get all the way to this part and there's still a problem, then it's time to have an audiologist take a look at the hearing device. So with BTE style hearing aids, one of the most common problems is that the tubing itself has gotten too hard over time. Generally, tubing needs to be changed about once every 6 months, but that can vary depending on the patient. Some patients have a little bit extra oil, and that oil is going to harden the tubing more quickly than average. And vice versa, also sometimes some patients have more cerumen or wax, and that's another thing that can speed up the hardening of the tubing. So tubing generally should be nice and pliant and really flexible. There should be a lot of give to it. I have a good example of a hard tubing. If you try to flex this, it just does not do very much. So this is a good example of tubing that needs to be changed. There's multiple different types of tubing, but generally in the pediatric population, you're going to see this kind of tubing with a locking mechanism on it. That is to help the ear mold stay on the tubing and not fall off. The ones that don't have the locking mechanism, over time as the tubing shrinks and gets hardened, can fall off. So either way, just make sure that you know what type of tubing to have on hand for your patients, whatever they're wearing, whether it's the TRS tubing or whether it's the tubing without the lock. The other thing that you might find is having debris down inside the ear mold. So you'll want to take the tubing off of the tone hook, and some kits come with a little air blower, and what you can do is take that little air blower and get it connected right into the space you're trying to blow wax out of, and just squeeze until the wax comes out. You can do that for the tubing that will connect into the tone hook, and you can also do it for the vent if the ear mold has a vent. You could put that right in there and let it blow out. The other thing that you can have on hand is just this ear mold tubing cleaner. It's essentially a little string that has a thick portion on it. And you can thread that little piece right through the ear mold venting area and just quickly wick any moisture or any wax or debris out of the ear mold. So there's two different ways that work pretty efficiently that you could use.